If you've not been following along, this is going to be a wild ride, guys. And if you have been following along, I've got the juice for you today. So let me introduce you to Zachary Kaplan, the Willy Wonka of game development, minus the actual redeeming qualities, but still the nightmares. The reason I'm calling him the Willy Wonka of game development is because he seems to be collecting children, going to Minecraft servers to bring the good news of Dreamworld, recruiting the kids as his Discord moderators that enforce the server's rules. Not sure why exactly he trusts the enforcement of policy in his video game company's Discord to 14-year-olds, but funnily enough, the 14-year-olds seem to be more mature than he is. So there is this weird extra element of sliminess to this project, not just in that it's an outright blatant scam, but that it's a scam that is targeting children purposefully. And then you have this adult who comes across to any other rational adult as actually kind of creepy and pretty mental.
what was an easy answer.
Pushing a product that everyone knows cannot be delivered. And before I really get into the nitty gritty of this, leave me a like on the video, leave me a comment, subscribe if you haven't already. These are the mechanics that let me know you enjoy the content. And that allows me to cater the experience and to make videos that you will enjoy more by knowing what you guys want to see. Now, this video will be the culmination of a lot of info that we've already previously published. And by we, I mean all the great content creators that have been looking into this and publishing their findings. Josh Strife-Hayes, Callum Upton being, I believe, the main ones. And funnily enough, the guest star who stole the show, Zach's ex-fiance. You know the one he lied about, and I exposed part of that lie originally about a month ago?
My fiance left me. My best friend Gary left me. My parents left me. We got so excited that I made a Discord channel, and it left me.
There's a lot of new info in here that I've either shown live on stream or been sitting on waiting for the time to put it all together. So let's start at the beginning of the banning, which I'm sure you've heard some details about, but there's more to this now. So I was told since the very first day my video released about Dreamworld that they were censoring people, essentially banning anyone who asked even remotely pointed questions or showed any form of skepticism in the project. You know, normal things for a project that is crowdfunded because the nature of the beast. I was then linked an About Us page for Dreamworld that was hidden on the main website. You had to have the URL to actually get there and see it. This website shows the two founders, Wolf, which is Zach, and Garble, which is Garrison. The third person who was working at the company, you'll notice, is conveniently left out of this screen, and I can confirm that person in the very short amount of time since he was mentioned in the original Kickstarter has left the company and no longer works with them. This is admitted by the Discord mods, including one whom has since been removed from moderation and has shared new information with me, and we'll get into that real soon. On this page, you'll notice that the About Us clearly states one superstar ex-Google engineer, which is Garrison, a person who worked a single summer at Google as an intern, according to multiple sources that claim to know him, as well as another internship at another non-gaming company you might have heard of called Facebook. Then you have Zachary, a quote, serial entrepreneur with 9 years of game development experience. Now, if you go back to the Kickstarter, you'll notice not a single time in any of the documentation was any game development experience mentioned. Now ask yourself this, if you had 9 years of game dev experience and you were presenting a game in development to the public for funding, do you not think mentioning the game development experience would lend some credibility to your game project? Of course it would, right? Common sense. Well, people went into the Discord to question Zach on this point. Specifically, what games have you worked on and where can we see said games? Easy stuff, right? If you've worked on games for 9 years, surely you have a single game to show for that, something to back up those claims of development experience. They were, of course, banned for asking this, you know, just banned. Then I went in there and asked the same question, recorded the whole thing, not going to show it all here for the sake of brevity because it's already in my other video if you need that proof, but I, of course, was banned for asking this question. I messaged Zach privately and then he logged on his phone, and seconds later, I was banned. This ban sparked questions in the server. Why did you just ban Kira? He did nothing wrong. He just asked a question, which then prompted an announcement to be posted by Grit, which is Garrison in the Discord, which reads, and I quote, "Participation in this Discord is a privilege, not a right, and may be revoked at the sole discretion of company employees or community moderators. Please be kind to others." This was literally 3 minutes after I was banned for asking a question, so that was clearly in response to me. I was then messaged by one of the child moderators of the Discord and asked what I did wrong. I explained the situation and they went off to find out what happened from the two supposed adults in charge. This mod came back to me shortly after to inform me I was banned, and I quote, "Garrison said you were banned because you made derogatory videos about us, and that, quote, it seems he doesn't want to make amends, which upsets me a lot, but I'm sorry." Then people questioned Wolf about it, both in text and in voice chat. Wolf has maintained to this day he doesn't know why or who banned me, and has actively lied about speaking directly to me. As you can see in this screenshot, Wolf states, and I quote, "Hey guys, answered this question to Kira yesterday, actually. I've worked in Unity and even Flash back in the day. Ha ha ha. All personal projects. Blushing emoji." Now, here is my live recording of my Discord from that day. As you can see, I was banned from Discord before Wolf ever replied to me publicly, which means all my messages were subsequently purged from the server. And here is my private Discord messages with Wolf. Empty, of course, because he never replied to me. A little bit odd to maintain you spoke directly to and answered someone's questions when you've never once replied to them, especially knowing I can prove you didn't, you absolute fucking Melvin. But of course, he's using this publicly as a way to placate people. Oh, you know, Kira had concerns and I assuaged those concerns, you know? Then, of course, claims that he didn't ban me and doesn't know who did, but he will look into it. He's still looking, by the way, about 13 days later. This guy who will deliver us this amazing best game ever doesn't know that you can look in the admin panel of Discord to see who banned who. It takes 20 seconds to do it, but I'm sure he'll get there eventually. You know, it's only been 13 days. And of course, this couldn't possibly be because they don't want to publicly admit they're banning users for publishing their provable lies. You know, it's not that at all. Then, cue the voice recording of him also lying about me yet again. Caught on 4K, as the kids say nowadays.
I think he asked the question, one of your developers had like 9 years of game dev experience and he asked for some proof and...
Oh, was that his question? I answered that.
Oh. What was the answer?
Yeah, that's me.
What was
an easy answer.
What was your answer?
Oh, my answer is I worked in Unity mostly, and then I actually made Flash games back in the day, back when that was actually a thing, Miniclip and stuff like that, and most of them were just personal projects, but I've also put together several hundred pages of documentation and illustrations and some animations and some rigging and things like that for what's now becoming Dreamworld, which is really fun, but it was mostly just small personal projects.
So as you've just heard, that was his question. I answered that. Provably untrue again, because I was banned with all the messages removed before he responded publicly. Insert crazy man laugh, because this guy is an actual fucking clown.
It was an easy answer.
You know, just worked on Unity, just worked on some games over the last 9 years, a bunch of documentation. And then, of course, here's his fiance of 5 years saying that, I quote, "The only experience I'm aware of that he could be referring to is over the last 9 years, he has written stories that he would like to turn into video games. While I was with him for 5 years, I am unaware of any other experience with him game development that he may have." So apparently, in Zachary's world, due to the fact I've been watching porn for the last 15 years, I am in fact a porn star and director. Apparently, Zach also doesn't listen to the criticism. He doesn't listen to the YouTube videos. He just makes games with all of his game development experience, of course.
I mean, like, if you just had to have told him that, you know, this was your answer, maybe he didn't get the answer, but it probably would have helped your case, right?
We don't have a case, bro. We're just making a game.
Well, I mean, like, you know, if you obviously you've seen YouTube and all the information going around about Dreamworld, sounds like you guys have a case. You need to fight for your credibility, right? So the more
you know, Cody, I actually never listened to them. I just make the game.
Now, the person who recorded this was banned from the server for saying, and I quote, "Free KiraTV in chat the day after this was recorded." A very fair and accurate response, of course. Now, moving on, people asked me how I know that all the mods are kids, other than the fact that they admit to it. Here is a private conversation with an ex-moderator, the only ex-moderator over the age of 18. He confirms every mod except for him is a child. He was also removed from the moderation team for two reasons. One, because he confronted the devs about all the bans that he was seeing. And two, because he warned a very confrontational member of the community about their behavior. This member of the community just so happened to be a girl who had joined the Discord and been spending a lot of time one-on-one with Garrison in voice channels, and seems to be getting quite close to Zach and Garrison. The day after he warned this user, Garrison removed him as a mod. Then one of the 14-year-old moderators messaged this ex-moderator and told him Garrison had claimed he was harassing that girl. He then of course wanted to message Wolf, aka Zach, to ask why he was removed, but he had to wait for him to return from his 2-week post-Kickstarter success holiday. Yes, that's right, as soon as the Kickstarter was successfully funded, Zach went on holiday for 2 weeks, and once he returned, the ex-mod would ask what was going on, and as is tradition, Zach didn't know why, who, what, or when had happened, but he would of course get back to him after he did a thorough investigation. Been 2 weeks since then, and of course he hasn't gotten back to him. Guess it's just what he does. Here is one of the young moderators stating they do not trust Zach and Garrison. So you might ask the question, why stay? Well, this mod has also confirmed that one of the children is being led to believe that they will be given a job at the Dreamworld studio. And the kids stated, of course, the reason they were going to stick out with the moderation is due to not wanting to mess up their chance for a job in the future. This mod also at one point had access to the developer's admin panel and private discussion section where they talked about the game state. He unfortunately didn't capture any screenshots as it was before he knew anything nefarious was afoot, but he did confirm he'd seen conversations and the original half of a developer that was talked about in the Kickstarter had left the project weeks ago, basically after everything had started being brought to light. This mod also confirmed that Zach had privately bragged about having, quote, millions of dollars in outside funding. This is the fourth person to make this claim to me privately, despite the public numbers they've thrown around being inconsistent, sometimes 550k, sometimes 650k, sometimes millions. So how much money do they actually have, and why are they not telling people? Now let's talk about the character of these individuals. Everything I've been able to find out publicly and everything I've been told privately is that Garrison is a delusional narcissist who believes he is walking the earth like a god. Actual reincarnation of God King Xerxes.
I walk this earth like a god.
There's a lot of people claiming to have worked with him, gone to university with him, and not a single person had a good word to say. Now, I can't verify every person knows him, but some of them I have been able to. Maybe they've got an axe to grind though, so we have to take their testimony with a pinch of salt. In terms of Zach though, we've got this guy banged to rights for being a manipulative, compulsive liar. I was the first person to publicize a story about him lying to his fiance over an engagement ring. I had a few of the details slightly off, but I was vindicated in that the story was by and large true. A story that the fiance confirmed and went into greater detail into. If you guys ever want to know how good my info is, she even asked me where in the world I got that story from, as she'd never talked about it online previously, and only people extremely close to her knew the truth. The story she went over in that video was worse than the one I'd heard, and essentially the guy showed up to her red carpet event, proposed to her out of nowhere in a big show in front of all the cameras, and the ring was fake. Yep, that's right, this guy showed up out of nowhere on her big day, made a big fuss out of it, and engaged with a fake ring. She asked him that night, is this real? It's huge. And he said, yes, it is. She then accepted it for being real because surely the person she was in a relationship wouldn't lie about it, and of course, he did. A month later, she takes the ring to be resized, and it's fake. They couldn't resize the ring because it would have literally melted. The jewelers stated that the ring was the cheapest possible option you could ever find, even for a fake. She asked him if he knew it was fake, and he gave a convoluted answer, stating he didn't know, but he hadn't been charged the full price, and then made up a crazy story about ringing the jewelry store and the woman who sold him the ring had been fired for misleading people like this in the past. She asked how he didn't notice the price of a real expensive ring leaving his account, and he essentially said his dad made a lot of transactions and he didn't notice. She then accepted it and asked him to replace the ring with a real one, and she continued to wear that ring for 10 months and remain with him despite him lying to her repeatedly, showing she's a good person. And then they sat down to talk about the relationship because things wasn't going very well. And this was post-COVID, by the way. So he'd already lost his job months ago. She'd still remained by his side. He'd admitted to her during this conversation that he'd been lying to her about the ring the whole time and that he knew it was fake from day one. So he made up the story about the jeweler and his bank account, etc. So not only had he lied, but he'd lied about a lie and perpetuated that lie while manipulating and gaslighting her for 10 months about it. He then spent the next few days, and I'll quote her here, trying to gaslight me about the situation, claiming she was being materialistic and only cared about the price of the ring. He then started saying things such as, and I quote again, why should I buy you a diamond? Why do you deserve a diamond? He then continued the emotional manipulation and she broke up with him. Now, this is a condensed version of this story. I suggest if you want a real true account, go to the link in the video description, watch her video. It's really worthwhile. The reason I think this information is important is because it goes to show that Zach is not to be trusted by a single individual on this planet. If he can lie for 10 months to the person he loves the most in the world, manipulate her, gaslight her, and then use that situation to disingenuously try and garner sympathy from a community, despite being the person in the wrong entirely, he's not to be trusted on anything going forward. That is absolutely disgusting behavior and speaks to this man's lack of credibility and his character in general. Now, this video is already getting kind of long and this is going over a tiny slither of information. This is a topic myself and the other creators that have covered it so far will likely go into more depth constantly as new evidence comes to light. I just want to highlight a few other things real quick since I can lend my platform and my credibility I built up over the years to these claims made by some other creators that have posted these things publicly already. Callum Upton has a video where he goes through some aspects of the project, one of which being a claim that someone high up on Y Combinator has contacted him, speaking about Garrison's connections to the platform and how the Dreamworld project was rushed through the red tape as a friend bonus. He claims to have verified the user's authenticity, and I can confirm myself, I've spoke about this on videos already, spoke about it on streams, and I've had similar experiences and conversations with at least three people I deem credible. One of which being the person who knows these guys so closely that they were able to leak the story to me about the ring a month before it was ever publicized. I've confirmed the accuracy of that source from, as I mentioned before, the ring story, being so close to Zach and his fiance that there's no way I can see this being made up. The implication of this is absolutely huge, make no mistake. I lay it out for you so you can really get the picture. The reason why Combinator is prestigious is because investors know that once they see a project on that platform and confirmed, they believe it has been through such a rigorous vetting process that it's a viable project. I've had this conversation with a Y Combinator venture capitalist firm, and they are under the impression that this is a legit project based solely upon that information. Being on the platform of Y Combinator is all that they need to give it a green check mark and say, we can invest money into this. Which means people are throwing hundreds of thousands of dollars of investment at a game they believe to have been thoroughly investigated and vetted by the usual proper channels. If this project made it to the platform through nothing but sheer nepotism and not through any form of merit, that calls into question not only Dreamworld, but the authenticity, safety, and credibility of the entire Y Combinator platform for future projects and all investors. If this is the case, it has a much wider implication for the platform than just simply a single bad investment when this project undoubtedly cannot materialize in the way that they claim. I was comfortable publishing this information a few weeks ago, and I can now back up again what Callum's saying. If they're different sources or not, I can't say because we've not shared this information. But if he's got the same people that I've been speaking to, then they seem to be credible people. Now onto the actual development real quick. This game is literally a fucking Frankenstein of cut and paste code from other people's work. Callum's published this information already, so I'll not go too in depth on it. But if his emails and DMs look anything like mine, there are hundreds of developers at this point poring over this game, discovering new things daily, sending them to us to cover. I've got folders full of findings just on code and assets alone, and I can confirm that everything I've seen of this game is just a bunch of assets stitched together, some of which the company never even purchased or gave credit to, despite that being a stipulation of using them. And you will know from watching the original Kickstarter video, they never clarified them as being assets until people called them on it. This even goes to the backend code, the networking, being from developers that do not work at Dreamworld and are not properly credited. Remember how Dreamworld claimed to have already solved the networking solution for millions of people on a single game world due to Garrison being an absolute fucking G? Well, that's a provable lie, and the code that they're using isn't even his. It's literally copy and paste from other developers' work. At every level of this project, there is a real shocking reality, and this video could be much, much longer and include much more. This will not be the only time it's covered on this channel, because honestly, I can't look away from it. I just, every time they say anything, it just falls to pieces in lies consistently. And the fact that they're still lying publicly about me, yeah, fuck you. So I just want to say real quick before we end, guys, thank you very much for watching. It takes a lot of time to make these videos, especially in the research, but with the editing, the writing, things like that. And I would have loved to have spent more time on it, but it is what it is. Hopefully you still enjoy it. The way you let me know if you enjoy it, leave a like on the video, leave me a comment, let me know. You don't really have to say much of anything, but comments, likes, watch time, so watching the video for longer, really helps the video get pushed in the algorithm, which gets more views on the channel, helps me out tremendously, and I do really appreciate it. And then obviously more people get to get on the wild ride with Willy Wonka, Zachary Kaplan, and the Dreamworld nightmare that never ends. So yeah, thank you very much for watching. I'll be live on Twitch right after this goes live if you want to come have a chat about the video, and or anything else really. I have a Discord active there all the time, a Patreon if you want to throw me a couple dollars each month, and you'll get your name in the end credits of the video. And that's about it. Stay safe out there, guys. We out. Peace.